coming up in Wido's Astro Forum.
Is that a new supernova?
In my 8 years as an astrophotographer, I always advised you to get a decent planetary camera if you want to do some moon or planetary imaging with a telescope and switch to a dedicated deep sky astrophotography camera if you want to capture objects with your telescope in deep space. But now ZWO has sent me this camera. They asked me to review their ASIAIR 585MC Pro. And apparently this camera can do a little bit of both. So I have been testing out this camera and I want to show you what this camera is all about in this video. Let's go! The ASIAIR 585MC Pro is a color camera with a Peltier cooler capable of cooling up to minus 35 degrees Celsius below ambient temperature. This ZWO camera has one USB 3.0 output to connect to camera and two USB 2.0 outputs to power other devices like your filter wheel. The camera boasts a Sony IMX585 8.3 megapixel sensor with a pixel size of 2.9, full well capacity of 40,000 electrons, quantum efficiency of 91% and a video speed of 47 frames per second at maximum resolution. One of the first things I did was making stacks of 15 dark frames cooled at minus 15 degrees Celsius, and I was happy to see that the camera didn't produce any significant M glow from 30 seconds all the way up to 5 minutes. So far, so good. We are finally entering spring, and for dedicated astrophotographers like myself, this only means one thing: galaxy season. So during galaxy season, we have some constellations that are high up in the night sky at midnight that actually point away from our very own Milky Way. And that allows us to see distant galaxies that are often millions of light years away. So I'm going to use this new ASIAIR 585MC Pro camera to try and capture some of these distant galaxies in the night sky. Done! So some of you folks probably expected me to get my Edge HD long focal length telescope to capture these tiny galaxies in the night sky. I have been dying to try out my new grab and go setup, so maybe I should call it grab and grow, by the way, because it's about 10 kilograms total weight. But here you can see my FF80 80 millimeter aperture 600 millimeter focal length telescope, and I paired it with my ASIAIR 585MC Pro, and this will get me to about 1 arc second per pixel, which actually might be good enough to capture some of these tiny galaxies in the night sky. And the astronomical seeing in the Netherlands, by the way, is often above 1 arc second anyway. So I'm using my ZWO AM5 harmonic drive mount and I'm controlling my Astrogear using the ASIAIR Plus. I know it only accepts ZWO cameras, but super easy to control and capture objects in the night sky with this tiny little ASIAIR Plus. And I can power this entire rig using only this one battery station, though this is the C-Techie GT200. So anyway, let's see how it goes.
Thank you.
Hi folks, so it turns out I was a little bit greedy and I tried to capture four different galaxies with the ASI585MC Pro, and I spent about 5 hours for each individual galaxy. That's about 3 hours to capture each galaxy in color and 2 hours to capture each galaxy in H-alpha narrowband. I processed the pictures using PixInsight and Photoshop, and let me show you the results.